stablecoins. The name is a bit of a misnomer. In theory, stablecoin prices are pegged to various fiat currencies or hard monies, like gold or silver, in an effort to keep the crypto token's price, you guessed it, stable. The benefits to a business that a stable token could provide are great. A stablecoin makes finance far easier than a volatile coin. Since the price is predictable, budgeting becomes less of a headache. But in practice, this is a tough solution to make work. Take DAI, for instance. The stablecoin designed by the Ethereum project MakerDAO. In the last 3 years, MakerDAO has become the most popular decentralized finance application on Ethereum. The MakerDAO project includes two tokens, MKR and DAI. DAI is the stablecoin, MKR is the governance token. To understand the MakerDAO system, it's important to note its role as a lending platform. So let's get into it. While both tokens can be purchased directly on exchanges, DAI is created when users of the system lock up Ether. When users lock up ETH, they can withdraw DAI, which maintains a soft peg to the US dollar. Users can withdraw up to 2/3 of the value of Ether that was locked up. There's currently over $400 million in Ether locked up in MakerDAO. So someone depositing $300 in ETH at today's prices could then borrow up to around 50,000 DAI, which would be worth roughly $50,000. Yet because the price of Ether fluctuates so much, the MakerDAO system encourages users to over-collateralize, meaning they'll have to lock in more Ether than they'll get back in DAI. The minimum amount a user must collateralize their DAI loan with ETH is 1.5 times. But people usually collateralize much more. Much like a traditional credit card, DAI loans accrue interest. In January, the interest rate, which is called the stability fee, for a DAI loan was 0.5%. Sounds like a good interest rate compared to the range banks charge, anywhere from 10% to 30%, depending on a person's credit score. But that low rate hasn't remained. Over the last couple months, DAI interest rates have fluctuated dramatically. DAI's price, 1-to-1 with the dollar, is kept by backing the token with an equal amount of debt. If there is more DAI in the world than the market demands and oversupply, the price will drop. So the system began to adjust by increasing the interest rate on all borrowers in order to encourage them to pay down part of the amount they took a loan for or close the line of credit altogether. When people pay down their debt, they pay it with DAI. That DAI gets burnt or destroyed when they do, which contracts the overall supply. A smaller supply should drive the price back up, and that's what happened in recent months. In order to close a loan, the user can only repay the principal with DAI. They have to repay the interest accrued in MKR. Both those coins are then burned as debt gets retired. DAI is destroyed because DAI is only backed by debt. So without that debt in the ecosystem, those coins are not needed. MKR is destroyed as an incentive for the MakerDAO community. With a present supply of roughly 1 million, destroying some of those MKR tokens makes the price of the rest appreciate or go up. A DAI loan could also be liquidated automatically. Should a person's collateral dip below the minimum 150%, the system will liquidate their ETH holdings automatically with a 13% penalty fee. That's on top of the interest owed as well. It's a fee big enough few users want to get hit with. This is why the rapid increase in the interest rate has been so controversial. While it was clear to everyone participating in the ecosystem that interest rates could be increased in the future, these rates have been increased from 0.5% to 19.5% over the past 5 months, which has pinched borrowers, especially those who didn't use the loans just to speculate on tokens. The cost to borrow has gone from an amazing deal to more than many people would pay for completely unsecured debt with a credit card, presumably to evade the sort of nosy questions bankers tend to ask before lending money. So who decides when to increase the interest rate and by how much? To explain that, we have to explain one more concept, a decentralized autonomous organization, or DAO. The idea of a DAO is that lots and lots of people can manage and run an organization, taking advantage of the wisdom of the crowd to make the optimal choice. MakerDAO is a programmatic loan system, but it's also a DAO. The DAO is governed by people who hold its MKR token. They get to decide on things like the interest rate, how much of one type of loan can be issued, and more. Because of this, and the possibility of appreciation, the MKR token has been attractive to hold. As long as people keep taking out DAI loans and repaying them, the value should go up as MKR tokens get burned and interest is repaid. MKR is currently worth over $600. So far, only about 1,000 MKR tokens have been burned. Holding MKR also gives participants the chance to be a decision maker in an interesting, new kind of financial organization. Collectively, these people pay attention to the price of DAI and decide whether or not the interest rate needs to go up and down. So far, they've been mainly choosing to drive it up. As pioneers of a new financial instrument, there's not much prior data for MKR holders to draw on to make an optimal decision. Nevertheless, as of this recording, DAI's price appears to have returned to a steady dollar valuation across major cryptocurrency exchanges and over-the-counter trading desks. What's more, MKR holders are now looking towards potentially lowering interest rates, given that the price of DAI has increased. In that way, MakerDAO functions as one of the best versions of a decentralized autonomous organization the industry can point to so far.